Hi all, in this tutorial we'll see how to debug a Flask application. So I have cloned a Flask tutorials repository on GitHub. You can do it too. So cd into the Flask tutorial and let me list the branches. Now check out Hello World Flask branch that has a simple default route, and let me create a virtual environment here. Python hyphen m venv space env will be the name of our virtual environment. So let's wait for Python to create our environment. Okay, so now activate our virtual environment. Okay, we have activated virtual environment. Now upgrade the pip. Pip is a standard Python installer package for Python. Okay, the pip is upgraded. Now install all the required dependencies for our Hello World Flask application by typing pip space install hyphen r requirements.txt. The requirements.txt file will contain all the dependent packages by this Hello World Flask application. So the pip will fetch all those requirements from Python hosted website, download it, and then finally install it. So let's open the Visual Studio Code by typing code space dot, because we are already in the Hello World Flask directory. It will open that and exit out of the command prompt. Okay, so we have opened our Visual Studio Code with the sample Flask repository. So here is the app.py. You can see few changes here at the very bottom. You will see nothing here, but when you open a app.py, which is a Python file, you will see the activating extension. So it will automatically activate all the Python extensions and also activate the virtual environment that we have created. If you open the environment, if you open the terminal, you will also see the environment is already activated for the new terminal that is being opened. So if you click on run icon, you will see the Flask which you have to select in order to create a launch.json file. So env is the name of the environment, and it will have those variables set. Let's close it. So it's actually located in .vs code directory, which is at the root of the application. It's suggested to check that directory into the repository. Let's go back to run. You can see the run icon over there. So let me type in a few variables to actually evaluate those values during the debug. So x and y, and also define a method that will be assigned to y. So sum will take two arguments, a and b, and I'll be assigning those values to z and returning the variable z in sum method. So this is just to show you the step into feature of debug. Like you can also debug into the functions that you have access to or within this project, and you will see this watch. You can add the elements that you want to keep a watch. So these are the two icons where you can start debugging on. So you can click on the start debugging. If you click on this drop down, you will see the configuration python colon flask, which is actually the configuration that it is pointing to, the one in launch settings.json file. So I have clicked on debug. Now let me browse the localhost 5000 port and put breakpoints before I do at X and return lines in our default route. So let me switch back to the browser and browse for localhost 5000 and hit enter. So let me switch back to VS Code and I see what's happening in there. Okay, so I see that the breakpoint has been hit by the debugger, and you will see this new tab has various icons like continue, step into, step over, step out, restart and stop debugging. And so the variables section has locals, watch, call stack and breakpoints. Locals are the local variable in the context. Watch is something that you explicitly want to watch around, say for example variable x and y, and as long as they are not evaluated, it will show the name error message. You can also add this is just like the immediate window for those who know Visual Studio and C sharp. So let me step over and see the value x has been evaluated, and again hit on F10, which is a keyboard shortcut, and you will see the y value has been evaluated. So this time I didn't went into the sum method, so I will give a different argument for sum method and watch it on the fly whether it's working fine. You can see the value here. So that's the feature of watch. So let me step over again and exit out of it, and if you switch back to browser you'll see the hello world. So this is about the basic debugging feature offered by the Python extension. If you are not sure about how to install, you can check the video in the description below how to install Python extension. So let me hit the endpoint by navigating to the default route. So here you can see this time we will step into the function sum, step over first, and step now this time we will step into the sum function and see what's happening inside sum function. So we don't have to put the breakpoint, but hit F11. Now I am into the sum function, and you will see the arguments has the values 3 and 9 for A and B respectively. Now step over by hitting F10. Now Z is evaluated, it will have the value 12, which can be visualized in local variables as well as our explicitly added watch variable. So you can also look at the call stack, who exactly is calling the current function. So the hello is being called by sum function, and you can see the sum is on the line return. So step over and you come back to the hello route. So that's how you make use of call stack. Like it will have a chronological list of callers, and you can also look at the breakpoints. If you have a big solution with the various files and the breakpoints spread across those files, you can just have a single point of reference in breakpoints section. So that's all about it. If you like this video, please do give it a like, and if you have any question, please do comment, and please do subscribe to our channel Titlinks. Thank you and have a great day.